A wounded Air Force vet and his family find medicine through snowboarding. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. First, officials identified a dead body found at Vail Pass Rest Area yesterday as a 42-year-old Denver man. Summit County Coroner confirms the man committed suicide of a single gunshot wound to the head. The family requested he remain anonymous. This is the 9th suicide in the county this year, and the 6th by a non-resident. Take it from Aubrey Hand. There's no place he'd rather be right now than on a snowboard at Breck.
It has been absolutely amazing. Perfect weather, perfect conditions. Perfect group of people to be with.
Aubrey is one of more than 100 wounded veterans in town for the Hartford Ski Classic. He and his wife, Jasmine, discovered the event soon after his leg amputation in 2016.
So I was blown up in 2012 and did limb salvage for 4 years, which basically is a lot of surgeries to try to save whatever limb they're trying to save. So for me, it was my left foot and ankle. And it didn't work.
The Hand family was big into hiking and rafting before Aubrey's injury. He battled depression during rehab and said snowboarding was the spark he needed.
Got up on the snowboard and rocked it and fell in love, and you know, now it's a passion.
And his wife agrees.
This event was the catalyst that brought us back out here.
Jasmine volunteered at the ski spec last year and, like her husband, found an extended family of adaptive athletes.
No matter what their disability, no matter what's going on their day-to-day basis, they just want to go have fun and just shred it.
Adaptive skiing and riding are not cheap. Aubrey says prosthetic legs made for athletics cost between $10,000 and $30,000, and computerized feet can cost upwards of $120,000. Military insurance covers his prosthetics, but civilian insurance often only covers 10 to 50% of the cost. Peak 6 at Breck opened for the season this morning with 3 inches of fresh snow on top of more than 10 feet already this season. Sarah Lococo with the resort.
And that is officially the earliest opening date in history for that peak, which opened at Breckenridge in 2013.
The Six Senses chutes remain closed for avalanche work. That area could open by this weekend. Peak 10 is scheduled to open next week after snowmaking wraps up. Elsewhere, A Basin's Montezuma Bowl opened today, and Grouse Mountain at Beaver Creek opens tomorrow. Tennessee Pass Nordic Center is open 7 days a week. Hundreds of Santa's Little Helpers dash down Main Street Breck tomorrow for the annual Running of the Santas. In the herd is longtime local Greg Gutsky, spreading holiday cheer.
After skiing all this great snow all week long, I don't really run anymore. I kind of just walk along and pass out candy canes to the kids.
The afternoon opens at 3:45 with a holiday dog parade, including more than 100 Bernese Mountain Dogs. New this year is a reindeer run, where kids wearing antlers gallop down Main.
Seeing 500 Santas and kids dressed as reindeer gather in one place is a spectacle in itself.
After the races, Breck flips the switch on more than 150,000 LED lights in Blue River Plaza. Day of race registration is at Napper Tandy's from 2 to 2:30 p.m. Colorado's own Aaron Blunck got his very first Grand Prix win this afternoon, scoring a 96.25 ahead of New Zealand's Miguel Portias in second and fellow American David Wise in third. Miguel's brother Nico finished just off the podium. For ladies, 16-year-old Kelly Sildaru adds World Cup halfpipe gold to her resume. The youngest X Games champ in history beat defending Olympic champ Cassie Sharp and American Britta Sigourney for the win. She scored a 93, 2.5 points better than Sharp in second. Tomorrow, our snowboard halfpipe finals, when 6 Americans and 6 Japanese riders duke it out for Grand Prix glory. Competition begins at 11 with the ladies. In sports, the Nuggets played the Hornets tonight. Tip-off is 5, and this Sunday, the Broncos play the 49ers on CBS. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the WEIS agency, Summit High boys and girls basketball are in Denver today for the second round of tournament play. Boys face Skyline and girls face Littleton. Girls swimming and diving is at the Demon Invite in Glenwood Springs. Tomorrow, Tigers wrestling heads to Golden. The 3-0 Breckenridge Vipers open a 2-game homestand tonight against Boulder. Game time is 7:30. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News.